Hello friends, we are going to discuss the treatment of depreciable assets under the head income from business or profession and capital gain. So we have in business or profession, we have the concept of block of assets. That means the same assets with same rate of depreciation are kept into one head and that is called block of asset. So for the computation of depreciation, we start with WDV as on the beginning of previous year. Beginning of previous year, that is 1st of April. In this we add purchases and deduct sale during the previous year. Purchases made during the previous year and sale done during the previous year. And the resultant figure is WDV at the end of previous year, that is 31st March. So in our case it is 20 and in our case it is 21. So now we have, here we have two circumstances. First, if the asset is put to use, because depreciation is available from the date of put to use. So if the asset is put to use for less than 180 days during the previous year, then depreciation will be available at half the rate of depreciation. For example, the asset is purchased say on 10th April 20, but it is put to use on 5th January 21. So the asset is put to use for less than 180 days during the previous year. So it is plant with rate of 10% depreciation. So on this particular plant, depreciation will be available at 5%. That means half the rate of depreciation. Now supposingly the asset is not at all put to use. B, if the asset is not at all put to use, not at all put to use during the previous year, then no depreciation will be available on that asset. But these two conditions are only for the asset purchase during the previous year. In the next year, no condition is like this. That means normal rate of depreciation will be available. So how we calculate? When we get this WDV at the end of previous year, because on this value we have to calculate depreciation. Now this value is divided into two parts. First, the asset purchased during the year and the original assets jo is block mein thi hi thi. तो अगर ये एसेट जो ड्यूरिंग द ईयर खरीदी है, अगर ये पुट टू यूज 180 डेज से ज्यादा थी या हो ही रही थी पुट टू यूज, तो फिर ये डिफरेंशिएशन करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. लेकिन अगर ये वाली एसेट जो प्रीवियस ईयर में खरीदी है, अगर ये 180 डेज से कम को पुट टू यूज थी या बिल्कुल भी पुट टू यूज नहीं थी, तो हमें ये डिफरेंशिएशन करना पड़ेगा. क्योंकि उस केस में फिर इस वाले एसेट पर, प्लांट पर, ब्लॉक पर हमें हाफ रेट से या बिल्कुल भी नहीं डेप्रिसिएशन लगाना है, और ये जो रिमेनिंग फिगर है इसके ऊपर फुल रेट से डेप्रिसिएशन विल बी चार्ज्ड. अब हेयर वी हैव टू सर्कमस्टांसेस कि अब क्या हो सकता है कि हमने कहा सेल को माइनस कर दीजिए, लेकिन अब सेल को माइनस करने के हमारे पास दो तरीके हो सकते हैं जब हम माइनस कर रहे हैं. एक क्या हो सकता है कि इफ दी वैल्यू एक्सीड्स द ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट्स इफ द सेल एक्सीड्स द वैल्यू ऑफ ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट, या फिर द असेट सीजेस टू एग्जिस्ट. दैट इज फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव ए ब्लॉक ऑफ असेट ऑफ प्लांट. There are two plant P and Q with WDV as on the beginning of the year 150,000. During the year we purchased R, plant R. This is block of asset plant with 10% rate of depreciation. And in the block we have two plant P and Q with return on value 150,000. During the year we purchased plant R for rupees 50,000. So the value of the block is 2 lakh. But during the year we sold plant Q for rupees 2,50,000. Now there are asset in the block. That means there are P and R in the asset. But now there is no value जिसके ऊपर हम डिप्रिसिएशन लगा सकते हैं, बिकॉज दिस इज सेट ऑफ दिस 2 lakh 2 lakh एंड दिस 50,000 विल बी शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल गेन इन केस ऑफ बिजनेस और प्रोफेशन. देयर विल ऑलवेज बी short term capital gain on depreciable asset. यहां पर कभी भी long term capital gain नहीं होगा. So if one asset is sold at such a higher price that the value ceases to be exist, in that case there will be short term capital gain. Now we have the second case. For example, we have two asset P and Q. We purchase plant R for rupees 50,000. Now what happened? We sold all the plant, three plant, say for rupees 2,25,000. So in that case, There is no asset in the block. So again there is capital gain of 25,000. Say we sell this asset at the 1,75,000. That means we do not have any asset in the block. So you are watching, in the first case there was no asset. So we get the profit. But here we are watching that we have certain value but no asset in the block. So we have 25,000 of short term capital loss. When all assets are sold, when one asset is sold at such a higher figure that it covers the value of the block, in that case there will be short term capital gain. But we have the second value, see, second option. There we have two circumstances. One, when all the assets are sold at such a higher figure that we have short term capital gain. But there is no asset in the block. So obviously there will be short term capital gain. And secondly, all the assets are sold at a lesser figure. So it seems that value is there, but there is no asset. So again, there will be short term capital loss. This only happens in case of depreciable asset. And the short-term capital loss or short-term capital gain is taxable in case of the fourth head, that is capital gain. In capital gain, we have two types of gains. The short-term capital gain and long-term capital gain. The cutoff is 36 months. But this 36 months has two parameters, 12 months and 24 months. Because we have just discussed the short-term capital gain and long-term capital gain. So we should know that what is the meaning of short-term capital gain and long-term capital gain. In case of short-term capital gain and long-term capital gain, the holding period has been restricted to 36 months. If the asset is held for less than 36 months or for 36 months, we have short-term capital gain or loss. If the asset is held for more than 36 months, we have long-term capital gain or loss. So that is why in case of business or profession depreciable asset, there will always be either short-term capital gain or loss because there is no segregation of this 36 months. We take WDV, we add purchases and deduct sale. We do not see when, for how much period these assets are lying in the block. Ye block chalta jata hai. इसमें प्लांट्स ऐड होते जाते हैं, एसेट्स ऐड होती जाती हैं और माइनस होती जाती हैं। कई बार ऐसा होता है कि सभी एसेट सेल कर दी तो शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल गेन और लॉस हो जाएगा, या कोई एक एसेट सोल्ड कर दी कि इतनी ज्यादा वैल्यू पर कि सारी वैल्यू ही खत्म हो गई उस ब्लॉक की। एसेट्स हैं अब वो पड़ी रहेंगी वैसे ही, लेकिन वैल्यू नहीं है। सो अब जब कभी नई एसेट खरीदेंगे तो नए सिरे से जब वैल्यू आएगी देन दैट ब्लॉक विल बी इन वर्किंग. Thank you so much.